The Joint Readiness Training Center at Fort Polk trains more than just American soldiers for their deployments. Marines, Air Force, and Navy have all been through preparation here. But the leader of the Southern Command, Marine Corps General John Kelly, visited soldiers from the El Salvador Army. The Salvadorans trained for 8 weeks at the JRTC for their upcoming deployment to Afghanistan. The visit and the deployment didn't come as a surprise for the Salvadorans. General Kelly explains our presence in the Middle East is not a solo operation.
The fight in Afghanistan isn't an American fight. It's certainly a fight for the Afghani people. But it's not an American fight. It's a global fight, I think. What's really remarkable about countries like El Salvador is they are so small and so out of the way that they have nothing really to fear from terrorism. Yet they're good and decent people who have stepped forward to be in the fight with other good and decent people.
West Central Louisiana is far from the climate and terrain of El Salvador. Not only did the Salvadoran troops have to adjust to the area, but they also had to learn to deal with the Afghans. El Salvador Army Lieutenant Colonel Jose Gonzalez explains some of the training involved.
Ahora estamos más confiados.
They really feel really confident with the equipment, the training they've been receiving, and also they've been having a chance to put SOP, Standard Operation Procedures, with all the equipment and the new radio equipment and vehicles. That way they can force that once they go to Afghanistan and have a better mission, successful mission.
These Salvadoran soldiers are the first foreign soldiers to go through the Joint Security Assistance Course and deploy to Afghanistan immediately after. Reporting for the Fort Polk Public Affairs Office, I'm Jeff England.